Today, we're going to be designing a sticker sheet that's ready to be printed. Now before we get started, I'd like to point out that when you order sticker sheets through Sticker Mule, designing your own sticker sheet is completely optional. You can simply create a zip file of the individual designs that you'd like on your sticker sheet, and we'll lay it out for you. That being said, you're going to have a lot more control with the final look if you design them yourself. To make it easy, we recommend downloading one of our templates. Once you have the template open in Adobe Illustrator, you can start dropping the designs onto the artwork layer. From here, you're free to scale, position, or rotate your designs any way that you feel necessary, just as long as it's within the sticker sheet box. However, each sticker must be at least 1 inch by 1 inch and have a space of at least 1/4 inch around it. It's worth mentioning that both of these requirements are measured from the sticker cut lines and not necessarily the artwork itself. If you're working with text, you want to make sure that it's outlined before you print. And to do this, all you need to do is right-click the live text and press Create Outlines. With your artwork in place, you can specify your own cut lines with a one-point stroke. A quick way for you to do this is to select all of your designs, copy them, paste them on the cut line layer, and then use the Unite function in the Pathfinder window. Once that's done, just apply the cut line swatch as a stroke, and we're going to know exactly how to cut your stickers once sent to production. If no cut lines are specified, we will automatically determine them for you. Either way, you will be able to approve the cut lines in your proof before you print. Now that you know how it's done, here are some tips for designing an awesome sticker sheet. Design first and adjust later. Focus on getting your sticker designs laid out roughly how you want them, and then if you decide later on that a certain sticker needs to be bigger or spaced further apart, it's usually a very simple adjustment. Also, consider making your stickers full bleed. If your designs allow for it, you can make your stickers full bleed by extending your artwork 1/8 of an inch beyond the cut line. Keep in mind that whatever is outside of the cut lines will remain on your sticker sheet when the individual stickers are removed. Finally, make the sticker sheet beautiful itself by adding non-sticker elements. A colorful background or a logo can add a really nice touch to the sheet once it's printed. Here, I've decided to add a light blue background and additional design elements to help fill in the empty space. Once placed, I'm doing some subtle adjustments to make sure everything looks balanced. Once everything is looking good, you can save your Illustrator file as is, upload it, and start your order. And that completes this tutorial. If you have any questions, feel free to let us know in the comments, and be sure to check out our other design tutorials. And if you found this video helpful, give it a like, subscribe, and you can stay up to date on future videos. Take care.